the many people, but my goal not to offend them. What I'm saying that the biggest terrorist is Allah of the Quran, the God of the Quran, the God of Islam.
You are going to make millions, millions upon millions of Muslims very, very angry.
I'm not trying to offend Muslims. I love them. Those Muslims are my family.
But you are going to offend people, and you are going to put your life in danger, aren't you, by doing this?
Some of them will be offended. Some of them will be offended. But I am sure, I believe, that many of them will woke up.
Some of them will try to kill you.
They will. They will. If they will kill me, they will kill this body. But the question, what about my soul? What about my ideas? What about my beliefs that I shared with everybody? Will they be able to kill this? I don't think so.
These comments are coming from a man who is not just any Palestinian, but the son of Sheikh Hassan Youssef, one of the founders of Hamas. Moussa Hassan is also a young man who himself, until just a few years ago, was president of the Islamic Youth Movement. And his denunciations of Islam are harsh and startling.
Every Muslim who read the Quran, if they allow themselves to listen to this Quran and believe in the same time that this is from God, I think they are sick and they need help. I believe that Islam is collapsing already.
Because it's collapsing?
It is collapsing. It looks from the outside, it's growing, but from the inside, it's completely collapsing. It's not giving answers to the people, is not improving their lives, is not helping them at all. Within 10 years, that's it. Islam is going to be over. If they torture, you're not allowed to say anything. If they kill people, you're not allowed to say anything. If
Wait,
they teach
you
something
they,
wrong.
They torture and they kill people in the jail?
They tortured and they killed people.
Their
in
own
the jail.
People.
Their own people. What Muslims, Muslim sheikhs, or religious people do? That they focus on only one part of Islam.
Which part do they focus on?
The part that they need for that time. If it's a war zone, if it's wartime, they're talking about jihad. They bring the verses that, so it's like very political religion. And this way, I discovered that the Islam is the most bipolar religion on earth. That you can find whatever you want.
So the Quran contradicts itself?
In so many ways. But I'm telling you, the problem is much bigger than Hamas. The problem is in the God of Islam. This is shocking, and unfortunately, this is the reality about this God. He is a God of torture. He is a God, the deceit God. This is what he talks about himself. Islam as a religion in general is a lie wrapped with some facts and truths, and I'm talking this with the authority of somebody who understands exactly what Islam is all about. And it's the biggest lie in history, in my opinion. And this is the biggest danger, that a quarter of the population of Earth believe that this is a religion from God. What I'm trying to tell you here, that your problem, my problem, the world's problem is not with Muslims. And Muslims, the majority of Muslims are great and wonderful people. They are my people. I know their pain. I know their sufferings. And I know their hearts. When you go to the Middle East, when you go to any Muslim community, you see their passion, you see their hospitality, and you get confused, even more confused. You say sometimes, those Muslims are better than many Christians. And we are not in a position to compare people. We are comparing ideologies. And I'm telling you that the minimum Muslim, the most criminal Muslim or terrorist has a minimum of morality, responsibility, logics, more than his God. If you read the Quran, if you allow yourself to understand what the Quran is all about, you're going to figure this out yourself. Go to the Quran, Surah 9, verse 5, and you will find what the God of Quran is asking Muslims to do against everybody. Now, it's not Muslims' fault that they were born in that culture. It's not their fault that they were born as Muslims. But what we're telling them, understand your religion before you are offended. Those are realities about their religion, and they need to recognize that.
Your father is the leader of Hamas in the West Bank. Didn't you feel that you are betraying your family, betraying his confidence, betraying the idea he dedicated his life to?
How did I betray him? By saving his life, for example, I'm not doing him a favor. This is my dad. I rather to die and he doesn't get hurt. I look like a traitor because I am doing what my people need, not what my people want.
You decided at some point to leave Islam altogether and you converted to Christianity, right?
Yes, I converted to Christianity. I am a Jesus Christ follower, and let me tell you something. I am not a pro-Israeli, and I'm not very fascinated by the work of the Israeli government of killing Gaza children or assassinating leaders and even terrorist leaders.
It's very obvious that they're going to try and kill you till the rest of your days, and still here you are in Israeli television without disguise, without fear, and I ask myself whether this is courage or total craziness.
Look, you are afraid when you do something wrong. When you don't do something wrong, when you believe in what you're doing, you're not afraid.
Masoud Youssef, in behalf of myself and many, many Israelis, thank you very much and thank you for this interview.
Thank you.
We have a problem with a gangster has been for the last 1400 years and he will be there for the next 500 years if nobody will stop him. And our war is with him. My war is with him. My God's war is with him. If Jesus Christ was here now, right now, and you ask him a question, what do you think about the God of the Quran and the God of Islam? What his answer will be?
I love Jesus immediately.
Why?
Love your enemy. That was the one that moved me from like deep and changed my life forever. I've been suffering for a long time. It's like my medicine became. It's not a drug. It's not like Quran. Quran is a drug.
The Quran is a drug, you say?
Islam is a drug.
Mousab is well aware that by speaking out, he could effectively be signing his own death warrant. But he shows no fear.
They can't kill my body, but they can't kill my soul.